start off this semester with something I personally think is incredibly fun, and I hope that you guys get there too. If you could take one and pass it back to the rest of the row, please. Thank you. There you go. What kind of intimidating. This is algebra. This is very basic algebra, and it's something I personally consider very, very fun. Today I'm going to teach you guys how to solve for x when it's the only variable. Eventually you guys are going to get really good and be able to do it with multiple variables. But if you could look at the top problem on the sheet, I'm going to write it out here. We've got 2x equals 10. This one is as simple as it gets. What we're trying to do is solve for x. We want to know what x equals all on its own. And the way that we do that is by messing around with the things on each side of the equation. We can get x all by itself, because right now x is being multiplied by 2. We get x all by itself by dividing by 2 on both sides, which is going to be x equals 5. Now, you're going to run into different things. There are going to be divisions and multiplications, additions, subtractions. Today we're mostly just dealing with those four. Eventually you're going to be doing square roots and other things like that, but we're keeping it pretty simple to start. So you can go down to the next problem. We're going to go down, not from across. We've got x minus 10 equals 3. Now, this one doesn't have any multiplication, right? It's not 2x, it's just x by itself. And what we want to do is we want to do the same thing to each side of the equation as we would. So you never just do one thing to one side of the equation, okay? And to get x by itself, what we need to do is do the opposite of what's there. So it's minus 10. So we are going to add 10. And what that's going to do is it's going to cancel out the 10 there and leave x by itself. But you also need to do it to the other side of the equation. So you're going to want to do it to 3 as well. So you're going to add 3 plus 10, which means that x equals 13. So fun, right? I can do it all day. Okay, so now that you guys have the basic concept, what we're going to do is I'm going to give you a small amount of time to solve each one, and then we're going to go over each one together so that we can cement it in your brains, and then you feel confident to do it all by yourself. So I'm going to go ahead and write this other one because it looks complicated. It got a little scary, right? That's the two things that we already did before. So let's write it up here. 3x plus 6 equals 9. Now, we're going to keep in mind an order. Now, you can do things in different ways with algebra. This can be solved in two different ways, or even more than two different ways. But the easiest way is to eliminate variables that are easy to eliminate, right? If we minus 6 from both sides of this equation, that's going to be the easiest way. But you can also divide first. It's just that you have to make sure that you do it from everything in the equation. So that's the same thing as subtracting. Subtract 6 from both sides. So if you subtract 6 from this equation, it's going to be 6 minus 6, which is just going to be 0, cancel each other out, right? Then we have 9 minus 6, which is 3. So what do we have then? We have 3x equals 3. Does anybody know what we want to do next? Okay, well, we divide. So we divide both sides by 3. And that is x equals 1. One of my favorites. I love it when things equal 1. Okay. This next one, You should know all the steps. Usually you want to do additions and subtractions when they're off on their own like that first. It makes it easier. But you could have done this problem differently. Sorry, I know I'm going to let you get to it. So let me rewrite it. This would have been a little more complicated, but it's still a valid way of doing it. 3x plus 6 equals 9. You could have divided everything by 3 first if you had wanted to. But it has to be everything in the equation. So if you're dividing 3x by 3, you can't just divide 3x by 3. You must also divide the 6 by 3. Because if you're only dividing 3x by 3, that's not the entire equation, right? And then you can divide 9 by 3, which would have ended up with the same answer, right? So you have x plus 2 equals 3. And then you can just go ahead and subtract 2 from both sides. X equals 1. Both perfectly valid ways to solve it. It just is usually easier to start by subtracting or adding the number by itself. Now I will really let you guys try to work it on your own now that I feel I've gone over everything you will need for the next 4 problems. So I'm going to write it up here. I'm going to give you guys a second to solve it on your own. Then we're going to go over it, okay? 2x minus 7 equals 5. Okay, I'm going to give you guys a minute to solve it. And I won't even hover over any of your shoulders. Just do a little work over here, okay? Everyone feeling like they got it? Okay. Now, remember, the second way that we did it is a valid way of doing it, but you run into fraction issues with that. So we're not going to go over that way. We're going to do the standard way of doing it, which starts by adding 7 to cancel out this 7 right here, and then adding 7 to the 5 over here, which is 12. So that means 2x equals 12. I would really like you guys to be showing your work, please, because when you're solving algebraic equations, it's so much easier to see why you got the wrong answer or why you got the right answer if you have all your work shown. So we then divide, correct, by 2, and x equals 6. All right, go ahead and go on to the next one. Okay, we'll get it up here. Oops. And you guys, I will ask you in a moment how you feel about it. Everyone feeling? You ready? Okay, what do we start with? Correct. We want to start by subtracting the 30 from both sides, which is going to give us 10x equals 20. And then what do we do? We divide, correct, by 10, which gives us x equals 2. All right. The next one. Thank you. pretty confident. Yeah, it's fun, right? It's just arithmetic within a variable ladder. Okay, what do we do here first? Correct. Minus 9. So we get 3x equals 9. And then we divide. Now, I've only been keeping it. X equals 3. Sorry about that. So, next section is the next column that we have. It's slightly more difficult. I've added kind of another variable, not like an actual variable, but like variable. We are doing division on one side instead of having it be like 3x, and we've added parentheses. But you better remember your order of operations, and you remember what parentheses mean. So I'm going to give you guys a chance to solve this on your own, and then we'll go over it. So if you're feeling a little overwhelmed, that's no problem. Don't worry about it. So we've got 3x plus 6 in parentheses divided by 2 equals 15. I'm going to give you guys a second to try it on your own, but if you feel flummoxed, do not worry. Okay. Some of you get it, some of you are a little nervous about it. Don't worry, the parentheses don't really change anything. You guys have done this before, just basic arithmetic, okay? Just adding that x in there. And we treat it like it's a number, but it's like a number that we can't define, okay? So notice that this equation, because it's in parentheses, everything here is being divided by 2. So that makes our job really easy, because all we have to do is multiply this side over here by 2 and just gets rid of that whole complication, okay? So, times 2, and then 15 times 2. That gives us 3x plus 6 equals 30, okay? Then what do? We're right back to where we were before, right? Minus 6, minus 6, 3x equals 24. By 3. X equals 8. See? Just the same and so fun. And now I'm a big nerd. Algebra is the best math, in my opinion. Okay. Now, on this next problem, I've added another variable, but you guys have dealt with negative numbers before, right? It's just the same thing as subtracting them. Okay? That's really honestly what subtraction is when you say 4 minus 2, the same thing as 4 plus negative 2, right? So it shouldn't trip your guys up too much, okay? Give you guys just a second, okay? Don't worry, we're gonna go over it. Don't be nervous. And I have a big old worksheet for you guys. It's optional. You don't have to if you feel like you've gotten the concept. It's not homework, okay? It's practice for you guys who feel like you need a little more repetition, okay? Okay, feeling good? Well, what's another way we could have written this? This would have been 4x minus 2. Same thing, right? So the negative number, it's not confusing. It's the exact same thing we've done. So what we're going to do is we're going to add 2 to both sides. 4x equals 8. And then do our old division again. X equals 2. You guys feel like you got this? Okay. Well, I'm only going to throw one more wrench in the works here. So go ahead and work through the next problem. This one is a little more confusing because we're putting all the concepts we just learned together. So again, please don't feel overwhelmed, but I am going to give you guys a chance to solve it on your own, okay? Jason, please stop passing notes.
Thank you.
Pass it after class. Unless it's like algebraic notes.
Okay, you guys remember about when you divide and multiply negative numbers though, right?
Right, because you need a negative to cancel out a negative. Do you remember that in your answer? It does make it a little more confusing. Okay, let's go over it. So, what are we going to do first? We're going to divide both sides by negative 2, okay? Negative 2, not positive 2. This is where it's going to kind of mess you up. Because that's going to turn our 12 into a negative 6, not a 6. So we have 5x plus 6 equals negative 6. And same thing we just did, right? It's exactly like the other problems. Minus 6. Minus 6. We have 5x equals negative 12. Now, I know that this one probably stressed you guys out a little bit because I threw in kind of a fraction for the answer, okay? Because a lot of times in algebra, numbers don't always turn out whole, okay? So, what we're going to have is x equals negative 12 over 5. I know, it's not pretty. Very frequently, it's not pretty. The rest of them are, I promise. This one is just a little bit. Is that too much of a wrench that I just threw in the works? Well, we're going to work with mostly whole numbers for the next week, and then we're going to be moving on to fractional numbers and decimals, okay? All right, next one. Should be easy peasy for you guys. I'll give you 1 second to pick it up, do it on your own. Okay. Yep. Super simple. Divide by 4. Divide by 4. X minus 5 equals 5. One's a little more complicated, guys. Now I'm looking at it. I may have made a fraction of the one solid really quick. I'm just solving it for myself. I made the sheet like weeks ago. I don't totally remember. Good, guys? Well, about that. That was a little more complicated, right? Okay. No worries, we got two more. Last one's a doozy. That one is just a sample of what we're going to go into in the next couple weeks. Don't worry about that last one if it stresses you out, okay? So we've got 6x plus x. Oh, no, wait, no. It's working. No, I did. I'm sorry. I'm totally forgetting this lesson. I'm going to interrupt you guys. We are going to learn how to do multiple x's. It's super easy, okay? This wasn't what I thought it was. When you've got an x like this, 6x plus x, you can just add them together, right? That's just 7x, right? 6x plus x is 7x. Right? Yeah, when you have an x like that, where you can use the regular arithmetic to add that, that's how you go. So divide by 7, divide by 7, x equals 2. Just introducing that little new concept. Sometimes you have multiple x's, and you got to get those x's together so that you can solve this, okay? So, try the last one on your own. Don't stress too much. It's a little more advanced. Just want to give you a taste. And then I will pass out the worksheet that you can do on your own. Again, it's not homework. It's not a turn-in. It's practice for you guys. So if you feel like you've got this concept down, great. Or you can start by dividing by 2 if you like. But I generally like to combine the variables together. So that gives us 2 times, that'd be 5x plus 5 equals 20. Okay? How's everyone feeling about this? You ready for the worksheet? Again, do it if you want. If not, totally fine. There is going to be a homework assignment tomorrow for this stuff, but it won't be very long. It's just to keep your memories really fresh and give you a little repetition so that it stays with you, okay? And I hope you all found this as fun as I did. If you want to pass your sheets up, we can just toss them